Welcome back and welcome in. It's your girl, Bro King. Get your sound.
Compromise. Because of you, I compromise. Because of you, I compromise. Many things we are not going to do, but because of you, I don't need compromise. Okay, Mute, would you come tonight? Should I come to yours or you come to mine? Any how we be, we can compromise.
Libra, sun, moon, rising, north, node, wherever Libra may be sprinkled in your chart, you are welcome right here. Hello, Libras. What's going on in your world, or shall I say, in your energy? Someone's in your energy, Libra. Someone has been thinking of you heavily. Someone has been heavy on the Dos Amigos. Tequila! It'll kill you. Anywho, back to you, boo. Hello to all of my new subscribers, my faithful, ever-growing few, and for those of you just breezing on through what it do. So Libras, let's jump into these energies to find out what is going on in your energy. As per usual, some or all of these messages may or may not resonate with you in the current passage of moment, so please do only take the messages that vibrate with you. If it's not what rings true for you, Libra, then most likely it's not what it do. You know what to do, don't you, Libras? Leave it on the counter. Thank all of you so very much for all of your likes, your shares, your subscribes. And for those of you that are already subscribed, do me a solid. Just make sure that bell is still blue so you know when your girl is uploading the next videos for you. So Libras, let's see what's going on with this person, this energy. More specifically, what's going on with you? Someone is ready to compromise. They may not necessarily be able or ready to fully see your way, but at least they're willing to compromise. So, angels, what do we have for my Libras? What's going on for my Libras right now, angels? Someone's trying to get out of their woes. Is it through this Casa Amigos or Dos Amigos? Casa Amigos, Dos Amigos, Tres Amigos. One of those. One of those Migos, damn it. Is their Migos. Anywho. We have, someone is trying to stay alive, Libra. We have the Nine of Pentacles. It could be this Pisces energy. Pardon me. Virgo. Interesting. What's going on with this Nine of Pentacles? This Virgo energy? Someone is wanting to step through a gate. A portal marigold could be significant. We have, what is this? The Chariot in reverse. There's a Cancer ready for war. Oh, but stuck in the clouds. Don't know which way to go. So someone has been fighting to stay alive, to come back into a portal, to a resonance, to an energy of money, of stability. And then we have this Cancer energy here with this Chariot in reverse again. Someone is fighting. They don't know which way to go. They're stuck in their head, in their mind, in their thoughts. What else is? We have the Page of Pentacles in reverse. More Earth energy, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. We have the Two of Wands. We have Aries energy. So someone is working on their money, trying to grow their pentacles, but it's like something is not blooming. Something is not, it's like this person is caught in a whirlwind of trying to blossom their money tree. Goats could be significant. So we could have Capricorn energy here with this Page of Pentacles. This Aries energy. Yeah, someone's trying to figure out which way in the world to go. Now, this person, whoever this is, knows that they have this decision to make. It's like their ships are in the bay. But it's like this person is looking off in a different direction than their ships that are there present for them. It's like this person has the opportunity of a lifetime to get on this one big ass ship, to take this one big ass mission. Let me fix this light here. There we go. You see this? The ship is over here, and this person is looking way off in the other direction. Almost as if they don't notice that this ship, this chance of a lifetime, is there. This Aries energy. What else, angels? We have the High Priestess. Ooh, Libra. Lavender could be significant. You could be smudging with lavender and sage. A lavender and sage bundle. Pomegranates could be significant. Yeah, you've got the universe at your feet, Libra. Again, there's this Lyran energy around you. Because you were a justice. You were the High Priestess and Justice. You were the Great Equalizer. That's you, Libra. So you've been cleansing, you've been purging, you've been clearing. Clearing the way. Studying, you have secret knowledge, wisdom you've attained. Working with the moon, working in between the moon cycles. The crescent moon and the full moon. Or the half moon could be significant. So you've been working on cleansing, clearing bad habits. Go ahead, Libra. This is why you were the queen of your throne, the king of your own throne, the High Priestess, the alchemist. What else, angels? We have the Nine of Wands. and Sagittarian energy. Someone is wanting to break free. Someone is willing to fight for this. There's flowers so abundant around you, Libra. Elderberry could be significant. White peony. There's those daffodils. What's going on with the daffodils? One more time, please, Angel. Things are slowing down. It's like they're slow moving, but they're making considerable progress. It's like things may seem to be moving very slowly in your life, Libra, but it's like even though things appear to be moving slowly, they're moving considerably quickly, if that makes sense. We have the Five of Cups in reverse. Scorpio energy. Someone went diving in the deep and didn't get what they were looking for. Now this person has had to come up to the surface for breath and they just don't know what to do. What is going on? We're going to find out. Libras. And something is not fitting together well. Someone may be having issues. It could be due to this. Casa Amigos, Tres Amigos, whichever friend it is. So friends may be involved. Interesting. Yeah, someone can't get you off their mind, Libra. Yeah, someone's been working on their money, trying to get their pentacles together, trying to grow their money tree. Now I'm hearing Money Trees by Kendrick Lamar. I said, hallelujah, oh, holly berry. Pick your poison, tell me what you're doing. Everybody gonna respect the shooter. But the one in front of the gun lives forever. And I've been hustling all day, this away, that away, through canals and alleyways, just to say, money trees is the perfect place for shade, and that's just how I feel. Nah, a dollar might just fuck your main bitch, that's just how I feel. Nah, a dollar might. Okay, let me get back into it. Anywho, Libras. So somebody might have said, fuck their main bitch. Is this what I'm getting? Stranger, danger. This Virgo who's been trying to get their money together to come back through this portal, through this doorway to abundance. It's like this person has bled out. They bled out of their own abundance and they're trying to put on this happy face, this smile about it as they get their shit together. So this person feels like they've lost love. There's no love on this person's side. So all this person can do is focus on getting their money, their pentacles together. So someone might have been driving past your damn house, Libra, and a vehicle not their own. Stalker alert. Stranger danger. Stalker alert. This person trying to get their shit together. So that then you saw Libra. That van that gave you a little spider sense, okay? This watcher, right on the floor, we have fake lottery tickets under this Cancerian energy with this chariot in reverse. So this person, whoever this is, whether this is this Virgo, this Cancer energy, someone felt like they were going to get rich off of you. So this shit has been stopped. There's been a halt to this. This is why someone feels up in the air, trapped in their thoughts about you, because their get rich quick scheme off of you has come to an end. Look, we have fake lottery tickets. Someone was planning to quit their job, just be lazy and live off of you, you know, eat off of your plate. Not even sit at your table, just lay on it. Oh, for real? So two other people could have known about this person's plan. Libra, whatever this is. To somehow, again, get rich quick off of you. We have fart in a pillow. Kindly pass it to someone napping on the couch. With this Page of Pentacles energy. Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. So whoever this is was also trying to pass you some shit while you were asleep. So it's like someone was trying to put a spell on you to fuck with your money while you were asleep. This is breaking the rules, what this person, what this energy was doing. This is why this was not successful. It did not come to fruition. It did not grow. It did not foster. Whatever this is, it didn't expand. What else, Angels? Okay, that's a lot, but they said take it. We have meatloaf of the world's first meatloaf sofa. So someone's level of comfortability has been slowly decreasing, falling apart. So this Aries energy, and this Aries may have a cat or a dog. This could definitely be a masculine energy. So this masculine energy who apparently is in separation from you, Libra. Now, again, this could be male or female, but it is a masculine energy. This person, again, the opportunity of a lifetime is sitting at the dock of the bay, and this person is just like, ho-hum, looking the fuck over here. What's going on? It's like the world is literally staring them in the face. The opportunity of a lifetime. The chance, one chance in the world, and this person is just holding on. To something else. What are they looking at? Jewels could be significant. Someone may smoke jewel cigarettes. So this person isn't satiated with where they're at. Whatever their situation is, it's crumbling. It's fading away. And this person knows that they have to make a choice. And it's very clear that the opportunity of a lifetime is being presented, is literally in this person's face, and yet this person is still looking towards something else. This Aries is looking at this Page of Pentacles in reverse. So it could be this Cancer, Virgo, Taurus energy, because we do have this Virgo energy here. We have egg on my face under the High Priestess. So yeah, Libra, you weren't going to be the one caught with egg on your face in this situation. So it's this person who got caught with egg on their face. This may have shocked you that this person was casting spells on your money to affect your money. So because this person's money is fucked up, you backed away from this person. This person sees you as some type of portal to treasure. And again, because their money is fucked up, they thought they would, you know, do a little dibble dabble on you to fuck up your money. And now the opportunity to go a different way is being presented towards this person. And it's the opportunity to be with you. But again, this person is already, Libra, looking like they're going to fumble the fucking opportunity, even though someone feels stuck. We do have this Nine of Wands energy here, this Sagittarian energy. This person who can't get over you, who really has been dancing, they've been excited, they've snapped into this spiritual warrior energy because they want to get out of their own mind. They want to take action to untrap themselves, unstick themselves, unfuck themselves from the situation they've placed themselves in. So they're defensive and they want to get out of this, you know, self-entrapment energy. We've got this Five of Cups in reverse. We have headbutt to the butt. We have hill of beans and we have rotten eggs. Let me see what is going on here. So this person feels like an ass. See, they fumbled. What did I tell you? This person fumbled. They juggled. You, Libra. Look at their team. This is their team, like you whole jackass. It's like this person is such a hard-headed person. You know the saying, a hard head makes a soft ass. So this person may also smoke too. Little TAC, little Mary Jane. Someone's been hitting that tequila and the MJ. Yeah, because they feel all hit and stuck in the butt. I said, well, what in the butt? I said, head butt to the butt. Yeah, because they're in a hill of beans. Listen, this person is a whole heap of, they're in a whole heap of shit. A whole hill of beans. Yeah, this person trying to get about that water. Yeah, they're trying to get out of their emotions. They're trying to be very surface right now. And then Scorpio. This person smells like rotten eggs. This person feels all exposed. They're all in their head. Their stomach hurts. and their shit stinks. And everybody knows it.
Let's get some clarifications here. Angels, why is the Chariot here in reverse? What's going on with this Cancer energy? Why is the Chariot here in reverse? Now somebody wants to be you, Libra. We have pee-pee dance. So something happened 7 years ago with this Cancer, Libra. It's like this person couldn't wait to release. There's something that this person may have been trying to release for 7 years. I don't know if this person, because there's a lot of dancing here. I don't know if this Cancer was doing this for 7 years, Libra. Gosh damn, that's a long time. This Cancer has been trying to relieve themselves to, you know, plop down on your fucking table. Not even grab a seat. You rude ass. You selfish ass. This Cancer has been trying to plop themselves down on your fucking table, Libra. To relieve themselves. To just piss all over your table. For 7 years, they've been working on this. Because, you know, their money's fucked up. And this person knows that you're going to be rich. And again, this is why there's been a stop put to this Chariot in reverse. And this person is very defensive, but they've been warring to get out of the clouds, to get out of their own mind, to get out of their own way, because this person is stuck. And why is this person stuck? Because this person was trying to rob you, you know. Lay on your table. Does this? What kind of savagery is this? Can I have a seat? I'll lay your lazy ass on the table. Okay. You know, because they have nowhere to sit. They have nowhere to lay. Their fucking couch is crumbling. And so, yeah, they want to come lay their lazy ass on your table. Eat off all your plates. Mm-hmm. Sneak you, you know, some dibble-dabble while you're asleep. Leave her a little dibble-dabble. Also, that they can make their money right and fuck up yours in the process. And Spirit said, where they do that at? Because we don't do that here. Angels, well, why is this Page of Pentacles here in reverse? So inquiring minds want to know. I do need this, don't you? My therapy doggy, because this person needs help. They need help. So this person has very bad reasoning skills. I just heard a lack of reasoning and deduction. So this person really does need help. This person might have sought professional help. This person happens to think that their therapist, their psychologist, I'm hearing, is an ass. This is a whole nutcase here. And we'll just leave it at that. This is a whole retarded ass person calling
a person with a medical degree an ass. This person needs help. What they need help with is fixing their money. So this person may have, again, gone to a professional. This could also be someone that they sought to assist them with fixing their financial woes. So this person could have gone to a spiritual advisor, I'm also hearing, to help them fix their money and to help them put a little dibble dabble on you. This is what has got this person caught up, because they broke the rules when they did this, when they consulted someone else who's a whole ass, by the way, to, you know, put the dibble dabble on you. And now this person that they consulted is concerned, and now this person is feeling anxious. What is going on? Anxious? Why is this Five of Cups here in reverse? What's going on with this Scorpio energy over here? This person was trying to throw funk in your air. I don't know when that card actually came out. Someone's first, middle, or last initials could begin with the letter P as in Paul, or U as in unicorn. Perrier could be significant. So someone knows that you're a killer, Libra. That you're the real spiritual warrior. Well, the real spiritual warriors, please stand up. Because look at this person. And this is this person. Because you're in their mind. And they're trying to break free of the clutches of the memories of you. Very defensive. Don't know what to do. Just so superficial. Ooh, just very surface. Very surface. Angels, why is this Five of Cups here? We have P on the seat. Because they're in a real pissy situation and this person wants you to clean it up. I don't know, maybe with your finances, with your riches that are due to you, that this person feels is coming in. This person's still plotting on you after 7 damn years. God dang, Libra. Now they're ready to what? Compromise. Now they want to compromise, Libra. Their money is still fucked up. And they just can't figure out how to walk back through this portal of abundance, of stability, of security. Things have been rocky for this person. They felt like their life, things have been at a standstill. They are caught in their mind, in the clouds, being very surface, very superficial. But this person is all excited for some reason. Libra. I guess they feel like something is bubbling up, or rather something was crumbling down. And you know what was crumbling down? Whatever their current present situation is and or was. So here comes this person, this long lost dust bunny from the past. Well, there you are. Been under the bed for a long time. Yeah, they have, Libra. Angels, what's going on here? What's going on with this energy, this person, this drinker? We have the dude abides. We have Earth energy, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, the Big Lebowski. Hey,
It's comedy, Libra. It's comedy that this person is still abiding by the same energies, the same rules of logic that they've always abided by. It's like this person is never going to get through this walkway unless they ground themselves. And it's like they're trying to, but they're trying to ground themselves by fucking you up. And I don't understand when and where that would work or balance out. But anywho, angels, what else? That's a lot. So you've just been working on getting things in order, Libra. And it's crazy because these energies are coming out in order. We have earth energy, water, earth, water, earth. What else, angels? So this could definitely be an earth sign. Yeah, heavy on the earth. Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Someone who's about to fucking miss the boat again, Libra. Here they go. About to miss the boat again. It says, for my whole life, I didn't know if I even really existed, but I do, and people are starting to notice. What did I tell you? People are starting to notice that this person fucking stinks. Whatever they've been saying, whatever they've been doing, whoever this is that this person involved in trying to cast spells or speak against you. Even if this person wasn't necessarily doing spell work, and for some of you, this person definitely was. Let me just tell you, someone was speaking ill words against you to others. And it could have been this Aries that they were working with. But again, whoever this is, Libra, this earth sign, this person was just plotting on your riches, on your treasure chest. See, this person has been a pretender their whole life. It's like this is what they've done. They seek people to kind of latch on to, and then, you know, not eat off their plate, but gosh damn it, lay on their table. And people are starting to notice that this is this person's normal modus operandi. This is just who they are. It says, do you smell that fitness? I do. So yeah, Libra, you've been working it out. You've been working on you. You've been taking care of self. You've been handling business. You've been cleaning and clearing and purging and settling down. Settling your energies, maintaining your peace. Because you're sitting on birthing a new universe at this time. You're reigning over your own kingdom. It says, bring out the gimp from Pulp Fiction. Do y'all remember that scene when they brought out the gimp and Ving Rhames and what's his name? You know who I'm talking about. I can't think of his name right now. Bruce Willis. But they were getting prepared for torture when the gimp came out, right? They put the ball gags in their mouths, and it was about to go down. So this person has been tortured by the fact that things in their life are crumbling. The facade that they put up with whatever connection they were just in, because I feel like whatever connection they were in just ended. Yeah, this person is saying that they've been through a lot. But again, the ships are in the dock of the bay and this person is looking the other way. It says, I have nipples, Greg. Could you milk me? So I feel like, Libra, you're in the space and energy, and I mean, we've all got nipples. Milk doesn't always come out of all of our nipples, because some of you here are gents. Thank you, gents, for tuning in. But back to you, Libras. You female Libras. You do have the milk, Libra. You do have the liching. You do have the milk, the essence of life. And see, if people would rather continue to, you know, go to the convenience store and get their milk instead of loving and living with the cow at home. Now, listen, ladies, I'm not calling you a cow, but you understand what I'm saying. Yes? Why go to the store and get milk when you've got the cow at home? And so you're saying, Libra, that you can be that supernatural cow. In the East, the cow is sacred. It is highly regarded. It is a life giver. And Libra, you are, you know, for better lack of a term, again, that sacred cow. You have the ability to provide. And you want to know if someone else can be at your side and provide as well. Like, do they deserve your energy? Do they deserve your milk? Could you milk me? Because I've got the milk, you know? That's what you're saying, Libra. I've got the milk. But if you want to be out here catching an egg on your face, oh, then you can go ahead and leave me out of that. And your ancestors, or these feminines, these feminine energies that have been around you, Libra, yes, ma'am, yes, sir, yes, you, lady, yes, you, man, high five, tribe, I'm talking to you, these feminine protectors that have been around you, whether you are male or female, are laughing at these people for plotting on you to plop down on your table. I think not. It says, I'm a sex addict. It's my cross to bear, boy, I tell you. It's a real disease with doctors and medicine and everything. Gosh damn it, I told you somebody went to seek professional help. Gosh damn it, and they got the nerve to call their doctor an ass. But this person is a whole ass. They've been out here showing their ass. And apparently catching something on their ass or in their ass. Take it how it resonates, blades of glory. Boy, yeah, this person getting cut up. Oh, this person went and got some cut up. However they got it. And they got cut up getting some cut up. Isn't that a gosh damn shame? This is what this person is trying to escape is comedy. That this person, who is this, Tiger Woods? Is this Tiger Woods? Quit playing. I'm Tiger Woods. I'm Tiger Woods. I'm Tiger Woods. All of these damn Tiger Woods. Because there's a lot of them, Libra. You wouldn't believe it if I told you. Boy, there's a lot of Tiger Woods out there. And they're catching hell. And they're catching what? Diseases. It's a real disease with doctors and medicine and everything. Popping pills. Celebrating and shit. Having pajama jammy jams. One night stands. And this person is trying to break out of this. But they went and involved themselves in so much, Libra. This Joker. Now everything is coming out about this person, their sexual addictions. This Virgo, this Taurus, this Capricorn that has been plotting on you. It says, all I have in this world is my balls and my word, and I don't break them for no one. Scarface. This person is scarred. This Virgo, this Taurus, this Capricorn, this Cancer, this Scorpio, this Aries. It's a lot of energies here. So this person is going to hang on to this sex addict persona. They're going to blame it on the alcohol. The Tres Amigos, the Dos Amigos, whichever one. Whichever friend, blame it on the alcohol. Whichever one they want to blame it on, because this person does not accept responsibility. This is a whole slacker that thought that they were just going to plop down on your fucking table. So much for true love. This person was not after true love. We have family, the Little Mermaid, and it's interesting. Look at this. We have a mermaid and we have the Little Mermaid. Look at this. This person could have been born in 1989. Yeah, this person's riches are just spilling everywhere. This person has been hemorrhaging money. It's like they've got these two cups before them. Just like they've got these two decisions or choices to take action upon. And this person is just sitting there fucking stuck. What else? This is... So, Libra, you're resonating in the energy of a wifey husband material. So you have become the master, the mistress, the queen, the king, the empress, the emperor, the high priestess, the hierophant of your own energy. You're someone who someone else would want to bring home to their parents. But you're also in that energy too of only entertaining a match, a pair. To you, who you feel you could bring home to your parents. Even if your parents may be passed, it's that type of energy. What else, angels? What's going on with this stranger danger? We have Immortal. This is the consuming family pressure of peers. So someone sees you as being immortal. Again, Libra, it's like you have this everlasting energy about you, everlasting gobstoppers. See, this person is still looking at you. This person who may have driven past your house, again, in a vehicle not their own. So this could have been a family member, Libra. Whoever this was plotting on your riches. This person who wants to kind of stay immortalized in that energy of just being a lowlife. It's like someone was trying to pressure you into not stepping into this high priestess energy. They didn't want you to see yourself for the spiritual, for the immortal, for the chosen one that you are. Rubies could be significant. Red garnets. You may hear six bells ring. We have nightmares, psychic protection, shield, bad dreams. So there's a decrease. We're going from 6 to 5. So again, something has decreased. This person being able to cast these spells on you to invade your dreams. I told you someone was trying to put the dibble dabble on you while you were asleep, Libra. Someone was trying to pass you some shit while you were asleep. Come riding in on their high horse. Interesting. These cards keep matching up. Look at this. Two white horses, huh? That's a lot of horses. This person may have a vehicle with a lot of horsepower. But yeah, this was this rush. Someone here may have a Mustang. Not a 5.0. Okay, it's the new Mustang. It's not the regular Mustang. That crossover Mustang or whatever it is. Hard-boiled eggs could be significant. Something happened in the summer. So you stopped seeing eye to eye with this person, Libra, in the summertime. Whoever this Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn is. Someone's name could be Rodrigo. We have call for help. The past is a prison. What else, Amos? They keep trying to end you, Libra. Gosh dang, when are they gonna stop this? The world will never know. This anti-hero just keeps coming out. So telling. It's so telling. Call of the night. This is two calls. This person has been calling for you, Libra. We have call for help and the call of the night. So we have the call for help, reach out, need for backup, admit your needs. What did I say? And this person has literally been trying to call you. There are so many flowers. Purple orchids could be significant. It's like the wallpaper is peeling off the walls. And both these pictures, the feminine has on a green dress. So you don't need anyone to hold you, Libra. You don't need anyone to So yeah, again, this person knows that things are working out for you, Libra. Look, it says, do you smell bad fitness? I do. These people know that things are working out for you financially, spiritually, metaphysically, because they've been watching you. They've been popping by your house, riding down your damn street, watching you. We have dodgeball. See, these people keep missing you. Now, they may be watching, however, they're watching, but they're still missing the book. They're still missing you. A true underdog story. See, Libra, that's you. You're the underdog. These people that misjudged you. So, again, we have the call for help. I told you they reached out to someone. Again, if this wasn't a psychologist, a therapist, this person reached out to some type of spiritual advisor. Someone's phone might have been on roaming. Someone's name could also be Roman. Yeah, need for backup. This person needed backup, Libra, to get their money right. So if they couldn't get their money right, well, gosh damn it, let me fuck up Libra's money. Let me call for help. Because I need help. They had to admit their needs. And even though they admitted their needs to whoever this donkey is, this ass, that again, that's now taking notes on this person. And this person is looking at this ass, whoever they consulted, like, well, what the fuck? Because something's not working. I'm telling you, there's been a stop put to this person trying to interfere with your dreams, with your journey. We have the past as a prison. Bitterness, grudge, refusal to let go. Yeah, this person can't let go. So they're about to get tortured, okay? Because your ancestors, your team have had enough of the shits, okay? It was all shits and giggles before, right? But now it's time to bring out the gimp. But now this person is like, oh my gosh, but I was supposed to marry Libra. I was supposed to sit at the table. I was supposed to have a seat at the throne. No, you weren't. And that's what this person thought. This person thought that they were supposed to have access to the riches, to the kingdom, Libra. They thought that they were supposed to have not only a plate, but a fucking seat on the table. Just lay down on all the plates, on the food, just savage drama. This is what this person has snapped into, and it's interesting because the cake is purple and so are their eyes. This person is filled with nothing but drama and they're hanging on a little bit too tight. And it's all because the shit in their life has crumbled, but they fucking missed the boat. See, I feel like this was the past. They could have taken this opportunity. The boat was sitting out there at the dock of the bay.
this person could have jumped on that big ship, this big opportunity to sail to a fresh coast, a new port. The world is looking this person in the fucking face, the opportunity of a lifetime. And even his companion, his pet, is looking the other fucking way too. They're both looking in the same direction. Do y'all even see the boat? No, because they've got on this cape full of passion. This person is led by their passions. What do they have in their hands? Wands, staffs, their loins. What's on top of their head? A red hat. A head full of passion, and they've got that pimp feather in it, don't they? Well, okay. And so now this person, past wanted to come out, yeah. This person who's got bodies, there's a lot of spiders around this person. Black widow energy, And this person definitely stuck. It's like their team tried to help them become unstuck to really try and get their shit together, and this person still wanted to be stuck and attached to the drama, and now that shit is crumbling. But now they want to come plop themselves down on your table, but your team says, we got another thing coming because the Gimp is coming out. We have her last day in the light, unexpected ending, surprise changes, sudden shifts, 10. This is what these people thought that they were going to bring to you, the High Priestess Libra. High Vibe Tribe, this is what they thought they were going to do, that you were going to spend your last day in the light, that you were going to be knocked off your throne. They thought they had the power, the ability to strip you of your throne. Libra, you have so many unbirthed, seated intentions that need to be planted. In this realm, to be birthed into fruition. That there's nothing these people can do to stop or prevent that. There's nothing that these people can do to make you, to cause you to spend your last day in the light. And for these people's transgressions against you, for betting against you, for thinking you were the underdog when really you are the High Priestess. It is these people who are spending their last days in the light. It is these people who are going to be the ones to end up with egg on their face. Not you. Because see, your team has your back. And they're laughing at these fucking people for thinking that they could, you know, eat off your plate. You want to eat off my plate? Here it is in your face. She thought this was for free, Craig. This whole anti-hero, this whole sex addict, scantily clad, this could be a masculine, this could be a feminine, this person dressed for attention, again, male or female. This person has a nice body and they use it to their advantage. The card earlier said, I smell fitness, don't you? So this person can smell the fact that things are working out in your life, and this person may have been working out a bit, hitting the gym a bit to, you know, make themselves a bit more appeasing to you. This person could be naturally fit. But this person has been trying to work out, to work some things out with you, Libra, this anti-hero, this person who's just a whole fucking party crasher. Maverick, risk taker, rule breaker. I told you earlier, this person broke the fucking rules when they decided to put a little dibble dabble on you.
and they decided to consult someone to help them do it. So everyone involved, Libra, everyone involved is getting tagged for this bullshit because your team said no. God said no, okay? The call of the night, daring, adventure, excitement. This person went on a whole excitement, a whole adventure filled with what they thought was going to be excitement, and what they got was a crumbling facade of a connection with whoever they went to go acquire it with. Again, Libra, there's all this Lyran energy around you, so you could be noticing cats around you, cats attracted to you, cats in the neighborhood. Let's see what's going on in the thought realms. In the realms of thought. Because these people, this energy, is not thinking clearly. Again, they're lost in thought. They're lost in the clouds. They can't make any rational decisions, sound judgments. This is why this person is, again, missing this boat. Not making rational decisions. Calling for the wrong help. A car hop could be significant. Did somebody go to Sonic? What else is going on in these realms of thought, angels? Everything is up in the air, these guards. Oh, if they could just land on the counter. I've already done my exercises. I'm just going to get these out. That is way too many angels. This person is flipping out right now, Libra. This anti-hero. Putting on the good front to escape this mental prison that they're in. But they broke the rules. And so they've imprisoned themselves. This is okay, I told you. The gimp is out. Your team is not having it. Oh, goodness. It's about to be some Pulp Fiction. Yes. Oh, that's not nice. Two more, please, Angus. It says, when you lose your shell right before the big reunion with all your old friends. I told you, this person has lost their stability. They've lost their pentacles. They've been hemorrhaging money. They could be hemorrhaging a lot of money right now. The fall is significant. This person is trying to ground themselves, trying to root themselves. This person may have been doing root work on you. But this person feels very naked, very exposed. Because they can't get their money right. And we all know the saying, if it's not making dollars, well, it's not making sense. And a lot of shit in this person's life is not making sense because they're not making any dollars. And this person can't fuck up your money because, you know, you're a chosen one. God literally said no. You will not touch my child. You will not harm my child. Because my child has many things to bring forth into this world. Things that I have seeded them with to birth. So these people have some real lofty ideals, whoever this is. Again, this this Taurus, I'm sorry, this Virgo, this Cancer, this Aries. It says when you have to go back to the Milkshake Academy after your milkshake license expires. So this person needs to go back to the drawing board. They really need to stop what the fuck they're doing because their license has expired. Their ability to affect you is non-essential. It's a non-factor. They need to really just accept this lesson and let you go. But this person refuses to let go because they're hard-headed. And a hard head makes a soft ass. This has expired. This has ceased to be. Them fucking with you, Libra. It says when you enter your pet's dream. I told you this person had a pet. In their dreams, they're trying to right after nightmares. Yeah, okay. So again, you left this person. This person tried to get you to stay, but all they wanted to do was play. Play with your mind, play with your time, play with your money. When you enter your pet's dream and find out that not only can he talk, he's also British. Oh my goodness, if these pets could talk, they would probably tell on this fucking person. Someone here has a British accent. I love accents, especially British accents. They're so sexy. But anyways, back to you, Libra. This person was definitely holding their breath, thinking that they could get some type of assistance to help them put this dibble-dabble on you while you sleep. So I don't know if whoever they asked for assistance, for help, has an accent or is from the UK. But it says, yeah, when you enter your pet's dream. And we saw that they went and talked to a donkey, right? So they asked this whole donkey. This whole Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, so they could have asked an earth sign. how to get into your dreams so that they could get back in your good graces, so that they could come in and share this abundance, this treasure that is due to you, Libra. This person is ballsy. It says, when all you know is fine dining and breathing and someone asks your name. Yeah, all this person knew was the high life, was having money. See, they had this Nine of Pentacles, so this person may have had a lot of money in the past. This person may have had a lot of money when they were in contact with you. But that is not the case in the present moment. Again, this person is trying to walk back through that door of stability, of finances, of abundance, because this person has lost it. They've bled out. They've lost a lot of money. And they've lost a lot of money because, well, they want to try and put a little bit of dibble-dabble on you, Libra, and Spirit said no. So this person, again, was very selfish. They were not looking at this grand opportunity that God was offering them. This chance with you. This person fucking fumbled it. They juggled it. They juggled you. It says when you rip your pants. See, you've grown from this situation, Libra. You've expanded into this high priestess energy. So this could have been a very catalytic situation for you. So wherein this person maybe thought that they were going to tear you up, Libra, no, you weren't torn up or torn down. You expanded, you grew.
and you grew and you elevated and you moved through and into this high priestess energy. See, you weren't torn up over this. This person was. Again, you're the sacred cow, where you are the high priestess, the alchemist, the wizard. Mm-hmm. This person knows how amazing you are. They do. They also know how badly they fucked up. It says, when your boss's eyes change into dollar signs. All this person was after was money. Was after your money. See, look at their eyes. You see that? There's nothing there, right? This person became an empty vessel. A soulless being. They put on the wrong wings, Libra. They went flying the wrong way. See, you switched into this high priestess, this mode of abundance, of taking care of self, of taking care of business. This is why you're out here birthing new universes. This is why you are on a precipice of great change, of great opportunities, possibilities. Again, pomegranates. God has seated you with many intentions that you were sent forth to birth into this realm, and they shall not be stopped. It says, when you're the biggest loser on the beach. Last one to the car, rotten eggs. You're a rotten egg if you're the last one to make it to the car. And look, their whole fucking vehicle is flipped upside down. Horsepower all fucked up. What happened? God said no. Take a seat. Get out the chariot. Call a tow truck. Someone needs a tow. Yeah, this person may run out of gasoline. Yeah, so they may need a tow truck. This person may run out of gas, but their chariot, their steam, their ability to cast any kind of dibble dabble on you, Libra, has been put to a stop. You are the weakest link. Because this person has addictions that they just don't seem to want to give up. So they're going to keep fumbling. They're going to keep passing the buck. They're going to keep not accepting responsibility for their actions. They're going to keep looking past that ship that's at the dock of the bay. Well, they see you leaving. They see you as an opportunity, but they don't want to treat you as the treasure that you are. And God said no. This little dibble dabble, this little help that you went and asked for, God said no. Oh, and you too. So whoever they went to ask for assistance again, oh yeah, they're going to get it too. Because remember, Pulp Fiction came up. It says, let the gimp out. So Ving Rhames and Bruce Willis, right? Now, Bruce Willis and Ving Rhames in the movie were kind of at odds with one another. But in that situation, Bruce Willis helped Ving Rhames, right? So these two odd people, the odd couple could be significant. These two odd people who may not have normally worked together. See, in the movie, they got out of that situation. They got away from the gimp, right? This isn't the fucking movies. This is real life. And the gimp has been let out. So, anywho, angels, you ain't what we have for my Libras. Mm-hmm. You gotta stay fucked up in these addictions, these sex addictions. I'm Tiger Woods. I'm Tiger Woods. Tiger Woods. Well, you go ahead and be Tiger Woods, okay?
Look at all this drama. Boy, I tell you. And there it is. So what does Yuni say? It says, apparently the world is not a wish-granting factory. From the fruit in our stars. Or the fault in our stars. Oh, pardon me. So this person had the whole world. I got the whole world right in my hands. I got the whole world right in my hands. This person almost had the whole world in their hands. It's right there. His hand is on the stick, okay? The world is right there. But no, he'd rather go double-fisted down on the stick, okay? Got a stick in each hand, just double-fisted. It's two-stroking it. Okay, that's enough. Yeah, this person, Libra, yeah, this person was all excited over you. Still very highly, highly sexually attracted to you. They like to use two hands. Anyways, but Libra, this person who had the whole world in their hand, or could have, chose to utilize what was in their hands. And it wasn't the world, so that's what they chose. And they went the other way. So God said, well, you get what you get. That's what you chose. So stick to the bed that you lied in. And this person lied to you, Libra. And now this person feels like the whole universe is against them. Talking about apparently the world is not a wish-granting factory. Actually, it is for the people in the back. Say it loud. Yeah, I said it. The world is a wish-granting factory if you know how to manifest correctly and if you do the things to maintain, sustain the energy to have those manifestations come to fruition, and this person does not. Because they do low vibrational shit, so as far as your wishes being granted, well, well, well. It says, I never dreamed my life would be so good. Lee Daniels, the butler. Now this person is on cleanup call. Now they've got a lot of shit to clean up. Listen, their ability to make moves on this, to make good on this little dibble dabble that they think was ever gonna work, because it was never gonna work. Let me just tell you, it was never gonna work. This person could have had the good life, but this person is addicted to drama. And this person wanted to bring that drama into your life, because that's what's popping up here. Nothing but drama. Nothing but Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy. And we did see this Scorpio energy down here. We have 2014 and 2013. Interesting. So there's been a de-escalation. Because we have 6, then we have 5, we have 2014, we have 2013. So again, 7 years. So this could have been going on for quite some time, Libra. It says, I just wanted to say that I'm a nerd and I'm here tonight to stand up for the rights of other nerds. I told you this person, Libra, it's comedy, that this person wanted to fight for the right to play upon your mind. To play with your money, to play with your spirit, to play with your finances, your money tree. Someone really thought that they could put a stop to your money tree. Poinsettias could be significant.
So this person is not the type of person to be confronted. People don't normally confront this person. This person just kind of moves around. When things start getting tough, when things start getting difficult, it's like this person just chooses another route. They're very surface. Again, very superficial. They don't get very deep. They could. It's not like they don't have the ability to go into the emotional depths, but this person does not. They're very comfortable on the surface of shit. But what's crazy is even though they're comfortable being superficial, being shallow, it makes them uncomfortable. Even though this is their circle of comfort, their level of comfortability. Do you see the confuckery that is going on? The twistedness of this person and their energies. Contorted. Inversion. This person is very inverted. What's up is down. What's left is right. Nothing makes sense here. And this is what this person has trapped themselves in. This personal entrapment of the mind. It says, do not go in there. Woo! But this is what this person does. Hard-headed. They went in to the donut. Onto the hot dog of somebody else. And when the shit crumbled, when the shit fell, Libra, now they want to come running back to you. And it's comedy. It's comedy to your ancestors that this person would even fucking try it. So their relationship fell apart. So they don't have any fucking money. And they're looking at you like you're a treasure chest. Like they're about to just come again, plop down on your fucking table, eat your food, you know, be a real slob on your time, on your energy, on your dime. And your team said where? Ace Ventura, pet detective. Yeah, they've been watching. I'm telling you, Libra, your spirit animals have been heavy around you for like the past like 6-9 days. Your spirit animals have been watching this person like a hawk. Well aware. Well aware. It says, just because something looks ugly doesn't mean that it's morally wrong. From Ladybird. So you saw the deepest parts of this person, Libra, and you could have thought that this person was a good person at one time or another. You didn't see them as physically ugly. You didn't see them as spiritually, mentally, emotionally ugly. But then this person started showing their true colors, their true intentions. You started seeing what they had planned to seed. And that was going to be a no-go for you. That was going to be a no-go for your spiritual team because your protector, Ladybird, that's a ladybug. You know what ladybugs do? Ladybugs eat aphids. Aphids are destructive to gardens, to plants, especially to flowers. There's a lot of flowers here. And see, Libra, you're growing your spiritual garden. And your team wants it to flourish. Again, you've been sent here, seeded with information to birth intentions into fruition. Because God said so. And so these people out here trying to play in your energy, trying to stop that. Time out. Anywho, it says you complete me. Yeah, Libra. This person feels like you complete them. Look at all the drama. Still with the drama. Still with the drama. There's nothing but drama. There's nothing but drama. We have drama, drama, drama. And then we've got a whole bunch of earth energy here. So this is definitely a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, but does not have to be. Take it how it resonates. Libra, this person just can't get over the fact that you don't want to let them lie upon your table.
It says the revolution has begun, liberated forever, domesticated never. This person is never going to change. They're never going to change. They're uncomfortable being who they are, how they are. But this person has made a conscious decision to settle for that. Again, they're going to continue to miss the boat. They're going to keep staring past that ship that is so clearly, cleverly positioned at the dock of the bay, and yet this person doesn't give a fuck because they're much more interested in pursuing and perusing the avenues of their passions. That's what this person thinks about. This is what they're led by. They're led by what's between their legs, whether this is a male or a female. You know what I say, Libra? Let them be great. They were told not to go that way. Do not go in there. Woo! Like, please. Like, goddamn. Hard-headed. Soft-ass. Libras, please do continue to utilize your own intuition and discernment to make the very best decisions for your highest good. And I know that you will. Again, I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you to all of you for tuning in, for your time, your energy, your presence, because without you, I would just be talking to me. So thank you for stopping by. Any and all pertinent information to this reading can be found down below in the description box. Libras, do have yourselves an amazing rest of the evening. United we stand, together we rise. Holla at your girl. Peace.